Winter is right around the corner, and it's time to wrap ourselves into rich, warm, luxury smelling fragrances. Hi everyone, I'm Joe Lima. Welcome back to my channel, Scented Moments, where we discuss everything about fragrances. So in this video, I have here 10 fragrances that are wonderful for winter, and they smell rich, complex, elegant, all of those qualities that make these fragrances smelling luxurious. In no specific order, let's get started. Now, the first fragrance from House of Rania J, it is Tea Habanero. Tea Habanero is a wonderful, daring, bold tobacco fragrance with tons of spices, oud, and a touch of an animalic nuance in here. And this fragrance is just dark, mysterious, complex, and really one of the best tobacco fragrances out there, and definitely one of the boldest tobacco fragrances out there. Incredible longevity. This is just to die for. If you want a different, bold, unique tobacco fragrance outside of those typical sweet tobacco fragrances that are out there, check this one out, Rania J's Tea Habanero. The next fragrance from House of Thomas & Monaco, Raw Gold. And this is the vintage Raw Gold, or at least the original formulation, which is now discontinued. This is the Eau de Parfum, now comes in Extrait, and it's different from this one. It's not animalic as this one is. This one is very complex. This has like dark chocolate, spices, amber, civet, tobacco, whiskey. It has like a boozy nuance in here, patchouli. And the current formulation, so you don't have and you have also coffee in here, quite prominent. And so in the new formulation, it's more resinous, more earthy. I mean, I would say that patchouli is more enhanced. You don't have the coffee as well as intense, as pronounced as in here. So it's similar. It's definitely the same fragrance, but I would say that it's like a preview of this fragrance. I would say that the Extrait is like a sketch of what this fragrance was, or a more, we can say even further, it's more appealing type of fragrance. Still smells amazing though, especially compared with fragrances that are currently available out there. Smells amazing, still performs well, but it just lacks that animalic deep quality that this one is. This one is really out of this world. It's really a modern luxury type of fragrance, and you don't see brands creating fragrances like this every day. High quality scent right here, the Eau de Parfum especially. It's Raw Gold by Thomas & Monaco. The next fragrance, it's designer luxury to the max from the House of Dior. It's Dior Homme Parfum, and this one is the original version, the original 75 ml bottle, currently comes in 100 ml, but still smells the same. The formula is really the same. Now this one is iris, all about iris, very butchery with rose and leather and sandalwood, and it's just to die for. It's one of my all-time favorite designer fragrances, and I really want to cherish this one. Oh man, it reminds me back in the day when I was starting to discover this hobby. I mean, I always loved fragrances and I always had my small collection, but I just started to really collect from 2016. This fragrance was released around that time, if I'm not mistaken. And I think 2014 maybe it was when this was released, but don't quote me on that. Now I'm not very sure. And yes, I remember the first time I smelled this one, I was just like mind blown, like never smelled anything like this before trying this Dior Homme Parfum first time. And it's still to this day one of the best fragrances ever released, designer wise, especially in the 2010s. Amazing fragrance right here. I mean, just like is Dior Homme, the original, which is a masterpiece, a timeless masterpiece, which is also Dior Homme Intense, and of course Dior Homme Parfum. This is luxury. It's like the luxury side of Dior Homme. Although, to be honest, Dior Homme in itself, the original, it's luxury enough. It's very elegant, very refined, very sophisticated. This just takes it to the next level. amazing, amazing, complex, irisy, bit makeupy, powdery, but very buttery at the same time. Rose, tons of leather, and sandalwood. Just a masterpiece of a perfume right here, Dior Homme Parfum, and it's a winter staple for me. The next fragrance is the Majestic Lion from the House of Chanel from the Les Exclusives. It's Lilion. And Lilion is the reason why I love this line of Chanel. It all started here back in 2021. This was released in 2020, but I just discovered this one in 2021. Actually, I do believe it was just in 2021 that was worldwide distributed. I think this was, for a time in 2020, just a limited exclusive release in the Middle East, I think in Dubai, if I'm not mistaken. And then just the year after, it's when they really then distributed this fragrance worldwide. And it was love at first sniff. And this, for me, it's also a winter staple. And as you can see, also I didn't mention in my intro, but as you can see, this is like a preview of what it will be, my winter fragrance list for 2024. This one, I mean, and also as a side note, some fragrances will be featured there. That I'm featuring this video will be featured in my winter list, but not all of them, of course. So Lilion is all about, man, it's all about labdanum, but it's not your typical sweet, gooey, syrupy, ambery type of labdanum. No, it's a very rough, raw, pungent labdanum with some citruses on top. You have patchouli in the base, and the patchouli, it's very reminiscent of the patchouli used in Clos-Mondel, which is also a masterpiece, one of the best patchouli fragrances out there. And of course, it has also aldehyde. Now, this is often compared with Chalimar by Guerlain, which I can see. I have the Eau de Parfum, and I definitely see, especially in the opening, there some resemblance, but I think it stops there. Then this goes really in a very rugged, borderline animalic, I would say, like very animalic, like labdanum, and with patchouli. The patchouli, when it starts to appear more in the dry down, it's when the labdanum starts to ease a bit more. But it's a wonderful, regal, majestic fragrance. It's really, I think the best word to describe this fragrance is majestic. Love, love this one. Lilion by Chanel. The next fragrance from House of Frederic Malle, no surprises here, The Moon. I mean, when we are talking about luxury smelling fragrances for the winter time, we need to talk about The Moon. I mean, we can also talk about The Night, and that, because that is even more expensive price-wise. I mean, it's double the price of The Moon. But I don't have it yet. Hopefully next year I will add it to my collection. But for now, I'm very content with The Moon. It's been one of my most worn fragrances of this year. It's been also one of my favorite rediscoveries, because as I've been saying, The Moon wasn't love at first sniff at all. I found it too sweet and just too underwhelming at first, but this year just clicked when I was giving a sample of The Moon, and when I gave it several tries and several wears, wow, it really clicked. This is all about raspberry. A very jammy raspberry with incense, spices, rose, and oud. And of course, it's my favorite current, my favorite rose oud fragrance. My second favorite being Alhambra Oud by Ramon Monegal, which is just also another fantastic scent that could easily be featured in here, but I'm not featuring it because I'm already featuring The Moon, so I want a bit more diversity in the list. And because this is my favorite rosewood, so we'll just stick with this one. The Moon by Frederic Malle, performance wise is just out of this world. We really need to go easy on the trigger with this one. At least I need to. It can be overwhelming, and it's a statement maker type of fragrance. It's a very regal type of perfume, so I highly advise for you to check this one out. It's very expensive, sample it first, and of course check by yourself if you will love it as much as I do. It's Frederic Malle's The Moon. The next fragrance is a warmth, it's an angelic warmth. And From the House of Guerlain, from Dillard et Lamartine, it is Angélique Noire. Angélique Noire is elegance to the max, and it's very luxurious smelling. It's a bitter green floral vanilla. It has a heavy dose of angelica, like it has an angelica seed, angelica root, and it has some spices, green, very green, bitter. And then the vanilla itself is a bit boozy and adds more sweetness to the fragrance. In the end, it's such a warming, cozy, yet elegant, sophisticated fragrance. It's really the most sophisticated vanilla that I ever smelled. Period. And it's so pretty. It's pretty, but not in the pinky cotton candy pretty. No, it's pretty in a very elegant way. It's beautiful, maybe the best way to put. It's such a beautiful vanilla fragrance, and it works in the winter time. I mean, this one really works in all special occasions. And it's a fragrance that, while it lasts long, it's not a fragrance that it will shout that much. I mean, it leaves a nice scent trail, a nice scent bubble, but it's not a fragrance that it will shout. Doesn't need to. It's a statement maker also because of that. People that will come next to you, they will smell you. And it's so unique. And it's, again, very captivating type of vanilla for being different and for being very elegant. Again, Angélique Noire, one of the best creations of Guerlain. The next fragrance is an oud fragrance, just oud. Of course, it has other notes in here, but the main note is oud, and it's one of the most natural smelling, best oud fragrances that I ever tried. It's from the house of Katana Parfum, and it is Oud Chaotique. Oud Chaotique is amazing. So Katana Parfum is an artisanal brand from France, and I do have a discount code in the comment section, in the description box down below, which will give you 10% discount, not only for Oud Chaotique, but any of Katana Parfum fragrances, including Discovery sets that they have. And I always advise to go first with the Discovery sets, the best way to discover a perfume brand and your favorite fragrances from this brand. Now, Oud Chaotique, I was also keen to mention, feature Mystical Indian, you know, Oud Pure Mystical Indian by Cadlage. But I've been talking about that fragrance for a while now. And also, this fragrance is a bit more complex. Oud Cadlage being also a natural smelling oud fragrance for an incredibly affordable price. I mean, under 60 euros. At least at Notino. I did bought it for 49 euros at Notino. But now I'm not sure, but maybe it's in the 50 euro mark. And it's a great oud fragrance. But this one, I would say that it has more complexity because it has benzoin, has vanilla, rosewood, cedarwood, and it has a bit more oomph in terms of performance overall. So that's why I'm featuring this one instead of Oud Pure Mystical Indian, but you can still go with that one, definitely. This is an extrait de parfum, natural smelling oud once again. And if you are an oud lover, I think this is really a must try. It's indie oud, so it's a more spicy, a bit animalic oud that develops into just a wonderful, resinous, dark, mysterious fragrance. Please do check this one out. Just like the entire Katana Parfum fragrances, I think it's a great experience. The next fragrance, unfortunately, it's discontinued, but I really wanted to feature this one because I love it. And second, you have alternatives. So it's from the House of Bulgari, and it is Bulgari's Man Black Orient. Now, this is an extrait, and you now have a parfum or extrait, Bulgari's Man in Black, but it's different from this one. It's more close to the original Bulgari's Man in Black, but I would say that the performance is a bit disappointing in the parfum. And here it's just immense, and it's so dark and complex. You have rose, you have oud, you have saffron, with the spices, with the pepper, with rum, with leather, that it's noticeable and part of the DNA of the original Man in Black. And here, this is a true parfum version. This one should have been still kept as the parfum version of Bulgari's Men in Black, not the current one. But well, still the current one is great, smells great. It smells as a parfum, it smells like a parfum of the original Bulgari's Men in Black, just lacks the performance. And I would say that also lacks a bit of depth in my view. And this one is just to die for. Also has a wonderful, sexy cardamom. A cardamom for me is the sexiest, one of the sexiest notes in perfumery. And here it's used so well. I mean, seriously, this fragrance is a very regal fragrance, especially for a designer. Unfortunately, like all regal design fragrances, like more mainstream designer fragrances, are discontinued. And this is one example, another example of that. But if you have this one, I mean, lucky you. If not, try to get this one. I mean, sample it if you can. It's really worth it, especially if you are a fan of the DNA of the Bulgari's Men in Black. The next fragrance, it's a luxury leather fragrance. Could have been Cuir de Russie from Chanel, which is my favorite leather currently. But because I already featured Lilion, I again wanted to have some diversity in the list. So this one is my second favorite leather fragrance that it's not currently available. It is from Hermès, from the Hermès Essence. It's Cuir d'Ange. Cuir d'Ange, it's so good. Such a masterpiece of a fragrance. Cuir d'Ange is all about leather, and it has this like terry leather, a bit salty, and you have some florals, musk, and this fragrance overall, it's a bit animalic, I would say. It's horsey, a bit horsey and animalic, with a powdery white floral feel, a bit salty. This fragrance doesn't have any sweet edges whatsoever. It's an incredibly unique leather fragrance, far from being Cuir de Russie and all of those classic style of leather. And it's not also like Tuscan leather / ombre leather style of perfume. No, it's a leather from Hermès. Very unique, and it's one that I highly advise for you to try. It's elegance to the max. For me, I think this is really perfect for winter because it has a performance. I think out of the entire Hermès Essence, this one, Cuir d'Ange, Ambre Narguilé, and I would say as well Violette Violink actually performs really nicely. But this one, I would say it's the one that stands out the most in terms of performance, followed by Ambre Narguilé and Violette Violink. But this one, yeah, again, is the one that stands out, and that's why for me it works wonderfully in the winter time. It's a bit more cold. This doesn't have like a resinous, sweet warmness. No, this one is more in the cold side of things, but it's so good. It's really, really good. I just love it. Highly advise you to check this one out if you have yet to. Cuir d'Ange from Hermès. And last, but certainly not least, the powerhouse of this list. I mean, this one and The Moon is also a powerhouse, but this one is already considered to be the Blue Beast for a reason. So this one is Interlude 53 from Amouage. So this is the extrait version of Interlude Man, and I mean, first of all, the bottle is gorgeous. Beautiful, beautiful bottle. A lot of people say that this is what the original Interlude smelled like, so the non-magnetic cap version of Interlude. I don't know, I never tried the original formula of Interlude. I have the second formula, which is already the one with the magnetic cap, but with Interlude written here next to the spray. And I love that one. That one, it's was love at first sniff, and it's very spicy and herbal right in the opening, with the oregano being very pungent, which can be, it can be very challenging and daring to some, but for me it's just amazing. Very smoky, resinous, dark, and this one has all of that, of course, but I would say that the opening is not as abrasive as in Interlude, the original Interlude Man. So the oregano here, it's more tamed, and I would say overall, I would say that it's a more of a tamed fragrance. It doesn't have the rough edges of Interlude, the original Interlude, so it's a bit more rounded. Nonetheless, It's very powerful, and the entire DNA of the interlude is here. So don't get fooled by the fact that it's a bit more smoother, because in terms of performance and in terms of synth DNA, it's still very bold, and it's still a powerhouse of a fragrance. This still has lots of frankincense, spices, oud. It has like a burn ashy quality in here, and it's just regal. It's a regal powerhouse of a fragrance, and it will be a winter staple for me, but maybe not to wear every day, definitely, but still, it will definitely be on my winter rotation this year. Guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below, what fragrances would you suggest within this theme? If you find value in this video, hit the like button, subscribe, check out all the other fragrance content that I have available, and see you in the next one. Thank you so much for your ongoing support, and take care, guys. Ciao.